Many stroke survivors worry about if and when they can fly after a stroke. Medical research shows a person can fly after a stroke, but they should consider the type of stroke they had, how long it's been since the stroke, and whether they want medical travel assistance during the flight. If you plan to travel after having a stroke, it's comforting to know that research has found having a history of a stroke does not put a person in danger during an airline flight. Having a past stroke does not mean a person should not fly. But if a stroke has been more recent or a person simply has concerns about flying, they should consider several factors before booking their trip. Type of stroke. The advice on when to fly could depend on the stroke. A full stroke involves the sudden loss of blood flow to the brain. However, many people experience a transient ischemic attack, TIA, which is known as a mini stroke that resolves without permanent brain damage. A TIA is like a stroke and is considered a warning sign of stroke risk. Also, some medical disorders that lead to a TIA could pose a very small risk on flights, according to research compiled by Very Well Health. Those conditions include patent a foramen oval, a paradoxal embolism, or hypercoagulability. It's important to know if you have those conditions. Timing of stroke. Experts may vary on when they recommend you can fly. The Stroke Association recommends it is probably best to avoid flying for the first 2 weeks. This is the time when your problems are likely to be more severe and other conditions related to your stroke may come up. In the most severe stroke cases, patients may want to wait as long as 3 months. However, with a TIA, many people are safe to fly in 10 days. Before booking a flight, people should consult with their doctor. Medical assistance. Some people who have had a stroke may prefer to hire medical professionals to fly with them. Doing so provides them with a high degree of security in making the flight and ensures they get proper medical care if needed. Such help is found with non-emergency transport, NEMT, companies like Flying Angels. Flying Angels provides a number of services that can support stroke victims when they fly. A flight coordinator books your flight, sets up all the arrangements with both airports and airlines, gets you through security, and provides a flight nurse to help you throughout your journey. The company only hires nurses with a great deal of experience working in emergency rooms and who have training in providing medical care at high altitudes. Stroke survivors may face challenges, but they still can live a full life. With any serious condition, those who have had a stroke need to practice patience and planning. Travel by flight is certainly doable if they have the right amount of support. Consulting with a doctor and a medical transport service can give people the answers they seek about flying after a stroke. They can also provide the comfort, care, and support they need to make the journey. For more information about non-emergency medical transportation services, such as those offered through our company, don't hesitate to get in touch. Visit our website or use our contact to learn how we can help. Thanks for watching, and if you liked this video, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe.